people on the cargo airline for taking stuff like that. Tony rightly mentioned we deliver across the nation, and so at this point in time, Port Harcourt and Abuja, probably only not like I said earlier, seven other states, where we actually have our own bikes there, and we have our own sort of like, you know, distribution center. So from Lagos, we airlift every day, we airlift stuff to all these places. Then our dispatch riders will pick them up in the morning tomorrow and deliver to you at home and collect cash on delivery. Inspect the product, and if you don't like the product, they'll come back 7 days later to pick the product from you and bring it back. Replace it or give your money back to you. Like you mentioned earlier, just engendering the trust. We do work with Cargo Airlines on delivery.
And what's important is, a lot of the goods that Rafael said, they are here already. Mm-hmm. So Nokia is here, LG is here, Samsung is here, BlackBerry is here. So they already have goods in the country. Our role with them, partner with them, is to help them sell. So for us, our business is not the important goal. Our business is working with the distributors and suppliers on the ground to help sell their items. Also helping local suppliers that are not as big as Nokia or Samsung to also sell.
In a way, you could think of us as just organizing the retail. The retail already existed. It's in bits and pockets all over the place. We are organizing it, and by organizing it, we expand exponentially the size of the market. And as we expand the size of the market, we employ, today, 8 months later, we're 350 people. But can you imagine the amount of employment that we've generated at our supplier level? We have hundreds of suppliers who were not doing the kind of volumes they're doing today. So with increasing volumes, we've had to employ more people. Same with the distribution network that we've built. Taking these products to, beyond the fact that we employ people who are taking dispatch riders and whatnot, we still use what we call third-party logistics service providers who have their own cars, who then come and work with us and just pick the stuff and deliver to the customers and their bikes. So all these people are not even among the 10 of it that I'm talking about. This is new business that we didn't have before.
Hi guys, TJ Kende, co-managing director of Jumia.com.
And Rafael Afando, co-managing director of Jumia.
We will start by introducing what Jumia is and who we are. So Jumia is Nigeria's largest e-commerce platform. So we sell everything from phones to books to clothes, all online across the entire country. We have several ways of paying. You can pay cash on delivery. What that means is you come to our site, place an order, you wait until it gets to you, touch it, you feel it, and then you pay for it. And we also offer other things to help you get trust. So you can do, we have 7-day returns, we have warranties on all our electronics items. And we also have delivery typically within the next day in Lagos and across the country within 5 working days.
I guess the only thing I'll add to that is that we deliver ourselves in Lagos, Abuja, and Port Harcourt. That really means that we have our own motorcycles in those places and we'll bring the products to your doorstep. And in the month of April, we'll expand our delivery footprint to 7 other states. So in total, by the end of April, we'll be in 10 states. Before the idea came, I wouldn't say we were friends, but we both went to have a business school together. But when I was leaving was when Tunde was coming in. So before then we met once for campus, just briefly, and that was it. But we had mutual friends together. So once we started toying, I started playing around with the idea. He also was at that point in his life. He was back in DC at the time. And I was just told by a friend, okay, you want to talk to Tunde. And then 10 days later, Tunde was in Lagos and started working. Yes, we do. Today we are the 5th most visited local websites in Nigeria. We just went past GTV. If you come to the site, you realize you don't have the assortment that we have on the site. Nobody else has. Okay, I mean, our delivery footprint, like I just mentioned, we're in Lagos, Port Harcourt, and Abuja. We deliver across the whole nation with our delivery partner, DHL. And like I mentioned again, in April, we're going to be in 10 different states. So simply, these are some of the metrics that show. And I guess in terms of brand recognition, we received a presentation from Google, and that showed that in terms of retail brand awareness in Nigeria, we and other brands, we started in August, and there were other brands like, you know, before, and the ASOSes, the Deal Days of the world, they had somewhere here, and Amazon was somewhere there, and the week before Christmas, we went past.
No,
we do. So we have a warehouse in the Kenya that we house most of our items. So I think now we're moving to a 4,000 square meter warehouse where we have most of these goods. So we stop at it.
I guess I'll put it from, we moved to our warehouse in November, and that was like a 1,000 square meter warehouse. But now we've outgrown the warehouse, so we're moving into a temporary warehouse that's 4,000 square meters. While we wait for our actual warehouse, which is going to be 8,000 square meters.
So we started as Kasua, which was the general merchandise site. So we sold mostly electronics, so phones, computers, TVs. And so we added a pretty sizable fashion business to our assortment. So now we also started selling clothes and boots, etc. And for us, wanted a name that had a broader appeal than just electronics. So something that was not known to be a shop like only buy things. But now you can buy everything that you want to buy for your household, for your wardrobe, etc. So that's what we changed.